In this video, we are talking about the nomenclature of hydrates. Well, what is a hydrate? It's an ionic compound, and it can be binary or ternary, just like we talked about earlier. But this ionic compound has some water molecules around each of the formula units, each of the ionic compounds. The thing is, okay, a lot of people see, when they see, at first see the formula for a hydrate, they see the waters, the H2Os. This is what a formula for a hydrate looks like. And they think it's a liquid. It's not. A hydrate is a solid. It just has these water molecules kind of packed in there between the ions, between the iron, in this case, between the iron ion and the chloride ions. So the formula for hydrate looks like this. It's always going to be the formula for an ionic compound to begin with, and then it's dot a bullet, then there's going to be a number. If there's no number there, that just means that it's a one. No number means it's a one. And then H2O. And so this is the ionic compound part. We also call this the anhydrous salt just by itself. When the water molecules are attached to it like this, it's called a hydrate. These are called the waters of hydration. And so we would say that this compound has six waters of hydration. So to name this compound, all you do is you name the ionic compound using the rules that we learned already for binary or ternary ionic compounds. And then after that, whatever the number is here, you just use the same prefixes that we learned with binary molecular compounds to say that number. Mono, di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, hepta, octa, nona, deca, undeca, or dodeca. And then we say hydrate to show that there's waters there. So to name this compound, okay, this is iron, and this is chloride. Now, because iron is not on that list of ions that I gave you, that of metals that only have one charge, we have to use a Roman numeral. And you should figure this out for yourself the way we did this earlier, but there are three chloride ions, each with a negative one charge, so that means that this iron ion has to have a positive three charge to balance. And so this ion right here is called iron three, and then chloride. So this ionic compound is called iron three chloride. And then we say hexa for six, and then hydrate, and we're done. Easy as that, easy. So now, when hydrates, when you heat them up, the water molecules go, they leave, they become steam. It looks like smoke, but really it's just steam coming off. And when we do that, that's what this equation is showing here. On the left-hand side of this arrow, we have the hydrate. The dot here means that these water molecules are interspersed or stuck to these ionic compounds here. The plus sign means they're separate. So this is what we would call the anhydrous salt, the ionic compound without the waters of hydration, and these are the waters of hydration that have left. So the hydrate has the water molecules attached, the anhydrous salt doesn't, and we write them differently, like this. All right. So what about this guy right here? Well, to name it, first thing we do is we name the ionic compound. This is copper, and this is, again, another of your polyatomic ions. So it's really useful to know and recognize the polyatomic ions. And so if you look on your list of polyatomic ions, you'll see the SO4 is called sulfate, and it has a negative 2 charge. Because the sulfate has a negative 2, we have to have a positive 2 on the copper, and that makes it copper 2, and the ionic compound is called copper 2 sulfate. And then we just say penta for 5 and hydrate for water. And we're done. Easy, easy. What about the other way, going from the name to the formula? Well, it's easy to recognize a hydrate when you're looking at the name because it has the word hydrate in it. So you see it ends in hydrate. And so we're going to look at the ionic compound first, which will be the first part of the name. Sodium is Na, and we know that sodium always has a plus one charge when it's an ion. Carbonate, again, another of your polyatomic ions. And if you look it up, it's CO3 with a negative 2 charge. And to balance the charges, we have a plus one here, a negative two here. If you do the X, you'll get a 2 subscript for the sodium and just one carbonate. So there's sodium carbonate right here. Then we put a bullet. Deca means 10, hydrate means water, so 10H2O. Let's do one more, just to be sure. Calcium sulfate dihydrate. All right, so the ionic compound first. Calcium is Ca. And calcium always has a plus 2 charge when it's an ion. Sulfate, another of your polyatomic ions, it's SO4 and has a negative 2. So they both have a 2 size charge, plus 2, negative 2, so they cancel out. Again, if you do that X, make sure, even though you get a 2 and a 2, you divide 3 by 2 to get a 1 and a 1. Got that? All right, so calcium sulfate, and then a bullet. Di means 2, hydrate means H2O. Got it.